What is up, YouTube? It's your boy Zuka, the Flame Prince, back with another video. In this one, I'll be reacting to the 17th track on the Slim Shady LP, titled As the World Turns. Just to get this out the way, I just recorded my reactions to Just Don't Give a Fuck, as well as the soap skits. It was a singular video, but that footage is corrupted. My phone didn't want to save after that entire filming session. So unless I find a way to salvage it, in which case you're probably not going to be seeing this message, then that's why there's going to be no videos for those. I'm not going to redo a reaction video. These are meant to be first time listens to Eminem. Anyway, without any further ado, let's jump into As the World Turns. I think I know the song. I must have heard it growing up. I definitely recognize this beat. Yes, man. As the world turns, we all experience things in life, trials and tribulations that we all must go through. When someone wants to test us. I just changed the lyric video because that one was only capturing his singing and how what he's saying. Yes, man. As the world turns, we all experience things in life, the trials and tribulations. I had to find a third lyric video, because those ones. Yeah. That hook seems contradictory because on the one hand, singing Marshall is saying, I don't know why the world keeps turning. I want it to stop spinning and let me off right now, which is a roundabout way of saying, I don't want to live anymore. And then the talking Eminem is being all motivational, talking about how we all go through trials and tribulation in life, but we have to push through it and everything. So that's a bit funny. I hang with a bunch of hippies and wacky tobacco planters who swallow their roaches and light up like jack-o'-lanterns. Outsiders, baby, and we suing the courts, cause we know it's fucking only get it through in the source. Yo, they never should have booted me out of reform school. Reform fool, taking the shit in the warm pool. He mentioned outsiders at the end of Just Don't Give a Fuck, and I thought that maybe that was one of the people he was dissing. Maybe that's just one of the crews he was rolling with. And also, it was either on Just Don't Give a Fuck or on Rock Bottom. I wasn't sure who he was talking to, but I assumed it was Benzino because he mentioned the magazine. And now he just mentioned getting a 2 in the source. So I think this is where the beef starts already. Never should have booted me out of reform school. Reform fool, taking the shit in the warm pool. So they threw me out the Ramada Inn. I said it wasn't me, I got a twin. Oh my god, a 2, not again. It all started when my mother took my bike away, cause I murdered my guinea pig and stuck him in the microwave. After that, it was straight to the 40 ounces. Slap a teacher and jacking off in front of my counselor. Last clown freshman. He's talking about basically his fucked up tendencies at birth, Slim Shady. I want to say I don't like the fact that his origin story keeps changing, but it's not really changing. It's like we just keep getting glimpses at all the events that led up to him becoming Slim. His mom took away his bike to punish him for killing his pet. And then after that, it was straight 40 ounces drinking liquor and slapping teachers in front of his school counselors. This is Slim because we know that Marshall was getting bullied and the teachers weren't doing shit about it. So I don't think it was actually... Yeah, I think this is more Slim's zany imagination. Maybe about things that he wish he could have done back when he was Marshall. Slap a teacher and jacking off in front of my counselor. Class clown freshman, dressed like Les Nesman. Fuck the next lesson, I'll pass the test guessing. And all the other kids, even him at the dishead. He'll never last, only class he'll ever pass is his dad. Maybe true, and I told this bitch in gym class that she was too fat to swim laps, she needed swim fast. Who, me? Yeah, bitch, you so big, you walked in the big panties and stepped on Jenny Craig. She picked me up to snap me like a skin. I don't know who Vic Tennis and Jenny Craig are. I assume Vic Tennis is like a franchise because it's a place you can walk into. But yeah, continuing, he was basically the class clown acting a fool, which I don't think he was. This must just again be Slim because he seemed like a quiet, shy kid. But Slim is like the outlet for all the rage and craziness that he wished he could have exhibited, I guess. And then even his class was like, yeah, he's an idiot. He's only going to pass physical education. And he said, yeah, maybe that's true. Until he walked into gym class and told this one chick that she's too fat to be swimming.
Yeah,
She put me up to snap me like a skinny twig. Put me in the headlock, then I thought I'm a guinea pig. I felt the evilness and started transforming. It began storming. I heard a bunch of cheering fans forming.
This man's a fucking lunatic. So when he was in her, the grips of this fat bitch, he basically felt at her mercy as much as the pig, the guinea pig, did in his hands. The guinea pig's like a hamster, right? Which makes me feel like he had this guinea pig in the headlock and then twisted its neck or some deranged freaking sacrificial shit like that. I felt evilness and started transforming. It began storming. I heard a bunch of cheering fans from. So he was still, in a sense, martial, right? If we go back to my earliest interpretation of the Slim transformation being almost werewolf-like, this is what this is calling back to now.
It began storming. I heard a bunch of cheering fans forming. Red epics by her hair, drug her across the ground. And took her up to the highest diving board and tossed her down. Sorry, coach, it's too late to tell me stop. But I dropped the
chain. She's dropping like a bomb because she's so fast.
As the world turned. To tell me stop. But I dropped the chain face down and watch her belly flop. As the world turns. Why this world keeps turning. These are the days of our lives.
So I did say, oh god, I'm so mad. That previous reaction to Just Don't Give a Fuck and Soap Skit is basically 20 minutes long. Even though Soap Skits is 30 seconds long, I yapped for like 5 minutes, basically talking about how soapies are kind of like what telenovelas are to Latina people. And then I mentioned Bold and the Beautiful and Days of Our Lives, and how those are like really popular soapies in SA, right, in South Africa. And then I speculated that that was going to be a tying into this song. And in the hook, he mentions Days of Our Lives. So I think that's meant to be the link there.
These are the days of our lives. These are the things that we must go through. Day by day. We drive around $1 million sports cars. While little kids hide to take from their parents like bad report cards. Outsiders when we sue in the courts. Cause we dope as fuck and only get a two in the source. Hypochondriac. Hanging out at the laundry.
That's the second time he's saying that. So I feel like it's the same first four bars it started the first verse with. Could be misremembering, but I'm pretty sure it's starting it the same way. I don't know what that's meant to be a motif for. Not necessarily the first four bars, but just that part. Outsiders and you're suing the courts because we dope as fuck and only get two in the source. I feel like that's really stuck with him. I don't know why he's using it as like a motif. But maybe it'll be explained as I listen to the song.
Hey man, we're all a raunchy, fat, white, trashy clones for ya. Dressed like a sailor standing by in the courts. Cause we dope as fuck and only get a two in the source. Hypochondriac, hanging out at the laundry mat. We're all a raunchy, fat, white, trashy clones for ya. Dressed like a sailor standing by, pay the garbage. It's almost dark and I'm still trying to nail a trailer park bitch. I met a slut, said what up, it's nice to meet ya. I like to treat you to a bagel and a slice of pizza. But I'm broke as fuck and I don't get paid till the first of next month. Sorry. If you care to join me, I was about to roll this next. But I ain't got no weed, no fillies, or no papers. Plus I'm a rapist, and a repeated prison escapist. So give me all your money, and don't try nothing funny. Cause you know your stinking ass is too fat to try to outrun me. I went to grab my gun, that's when the rats did it on me. With an uppercut, hit me with a basket of laundry. I fell through the glass door, started causing a scene. Slid across the floor, flew right into a wall.
I don't know what prompted this song. It seems like each scenario leads to him ending up fighting a chick. So I don't know if that's just meant to be shock value or what, but that gets a thumbs down from me. Song itself is still good, but losing points in the content part, which is like, why am I listening to it? I'm not even offended. It's just, I can't be offended by him constantly talking about beating chicks when I listened to and even applauded his tale of him killing his baby's mother.
Washing machine, jumped up with a broken back. Thank God I was smoking crack all day and doped up on coke and smack. All I wanted to do was rape the bitch and snatch her purse. Now I wanna kill her, but so I gotta catch her first. Ran through Rally's parking lot and took the shortcut. Saw the house and ran up in it, shot a fucking porch up. Kicked the door down to murder this divorced slut. Looked around the room, that's when I seen the bedroom door shut. I know you're in there, bitch, I got my gun popped. You might as well come out now, she said.
Come in, it's alive.
I walked in and all I smelled was Liz Claiborne. And seen her spread across the bed naked watching gay porn. She said, come here big boy, let's get acquainted. I turned around and run.
So this chick is also as psychopathic, if not more so, than Slim Shady. And she's into this kinky, violent, I want to say. Kinky, violent sex must have turned her on based on the change of tone that we just... Like, it's low-key giving me whiplash, how fast we change from he wants to kill her to now she wants him to fuck. But maybe she's into that.
Twisted my ankle and sprained it. She came at me at full speed, nothing can stop her. I shot her 5 times and every bullet bounced off her. I started to beg, no, please let go. But she swallowed my fucking leg hole like an egg roll.
Yeah, I did say I've listened to this song before. I remember I remember that imagery. I have a homie who, like, whenever I used to go to his crib, this is like early, like PS2 days, I used to go to his crib and we'd be like playing like Mortal Kombat or be on his PC playing like Go and shit. But we'd always be playing like old Eminem music in the background. That was one of his favorite artists growing up. I remember that the image of she swallowed my leg whole like an egg roll. And if y'all know Kirby, right? So they just like swallow shit and then take on their powers. I just had the image of like this fat bitch just sucking up. Anyway, that just triggered a memory. From one leg left, now I'm hopping around crippled. I grabbed my pocket knife, just sliced off a right nipple. Just trying to buy me some time, then I remember this magic trick. Go gadget dick. Whip that shit out, and ain't no doubt about it. It hit the ground, caused an earthquake and power outage. I'm shouting now, bitch, let's see who gets the best. Up that shit ain't crooked and fuck that fat slut to death. So you raped her. This song is such a roller coaster. And I wanna say for the most part, it's largely largely unrelated to the hook he gave. The hook was very misleading, as is the soap skits. I thought this would tie into that. There's really no connection out of him mentioning these are the days of our lives in one line in the chorus. It might also seem like I am a bit upset. That has nothing to do with the song. I'm still mad at the fact that the previous two songs I reacted to, the fact that that footage got corrupted, because I started recording this one like immediately after, so I am still a bit miffed by that. Anyway, that was my reaction to As the World Turns by Eminem. Cool song, dope song. Content, atrocious, but it was a dope beat. His rhyming was dope on there. I think those two things are probably going to be the most consistent parts of my Eminem reactions, to avoid saying the same shit like ad nauseum. I try and mention it like once or twice throughout the song and just leave it there, because it's almost like a given. Anyway, that was my reaction to As the World Turns. If you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and smash the like button, smash the subscribe button, share this video with other fans of Eminem you may know. But with that out of the way, I'll see you guys in the next video.